Until we started farming, humans were always moving. But when our ancestors began growing crops, they settled in one location. In many ways, our modern civilization developed with the beginning of agriculture. That was about 10,000 years ago, in an area known as the Fertile Crescent. Today, this region includes 7 countries in the Middle East. One theory suggests that 8 plants formed the basis of agriculture. Can you guess what they were? Number 8. Einkorn wheat. Domesticated in southeastern Turkey, Einkorn wheat has larger seeds than its wild counterparts. Its seeds can't disperse without human help. Its name is German for single grain. In 1991, hikers found a hunter from 5,300 years ago in Europe's Ötztal Alps. Poor guy had eaten just before his death, and when researchers examined his stomach, they discovered the remains of red deer, dried ibex meat, and einkorn wheat. Number 7. Emmer and Durum wheat. Emmer wheat was one of the first grains humans ate. Unlike einkorn, emmer and durum can re-sow themselves. Well, that's convenient. Some scholars believe that humans began domesticating emmer in the mountains of southeastern Turkey. Others argue that various people in different regions domesticated emmer. Today, emmer is the main type of wheat used in pasta. Number 6. Barley. Barley is a primary cereal grain that is still widely used today. In 2014, the worldwide harvest was 144 million tons. You can use it in breads, stews, and soups. More importantly, fermented barley makes distilled alcoholic beverages and beer. It's an important crop to Tibetans. They may have used it to sustain their Himalayan civilization. The grain even became a symbol of their resistance to Chinese annexation in the 1950s. Number 5. Lentils. Named for their lens-shaped seeds, lentils are a major ingredient in South Asian cuisine. Lentils are a pulse crop, which means they're in the same family as peas, chickpeas, and garbanzo beans. They're often grown on fallow fields as they can take nitrogen from the atmosphere and release it into the soil, making it healthier for future plants. So not only are they cheap and full of protein and fiber, but growing them is good for the environment. Number 4. Peas. Peas are another pulse crop. Its delicious seeds are inside the pod. Beyond being a popular vegetable, peas played a vital role in helping us understand genetics. In the 1860s, a priest named Gregor Mendel experimented with peas to better understand genetic inheritance, the process that passes genetic information from a parent to a child. Today, 3 domesticated species exist, derived from the same wild plant, P. sativum. Number 3. Chickpeas. Like peas and lentils, chickpeas are a pulse crop. They are an excellent source of protein and are the main ingredient in falafel, hummus, and many dals. The other crops in our list get planted in the fall and harvested in the spring. But to avoid disease, chickpeas get planted in the spring. Number 2. Bitter vetch. Researchers have dated the domestication of bitter vetch to about 9,500 years ago. Bitter what now? You don't know what bitter vetch is? Come on, neither do I.
Oh no.
Well, that's not surprising. It's toxic to humans, and eating it could kill you. So why would this be one of the original 8 agricultural plants if we can't even eat it? This crop is easy to grow and has great nutritional value for cattle and sheep. But if you prepare it properly, you can eat bitter vetch safely. Remove the seeds from the plant and boil them in water to remove the bitterness and the toxin. And number 1, flax. Also known as linseed, flax was domesticated for its oil. But it's been used for far longer than that to produce textiles like linen. Oh, I get it, linseed, linen, I got it. Evidence found in modern-day Georgia shows that flax was used to produce clothing as far back as 30,000 years ago. Well, there it is. We just explored the origins of agriculture. But what is the future of food? Could it be 3D printing? We'll find out on another episode of Origins of Food.